Yo, what's good, guys? Your boy Pat Music Production here from Producer Buzz. You know how it goes. Guys, today we're going to be looking at how to turn your vocals from sounding like this.
I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my zone. You never showed me love, only play games, I show you how it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, she's way past her demon time. Ignores me when she's
two, sounding like this.
I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my zone. You never showed me love, only play games, I show you how it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, she's way past her demon time. Ignores me when she's texting, I don't need a super lie. He was never in my zone, he was never in my zone, no. He was never in my zone, he was never in my zone, no, no, no. He was never in my zone, he was never in my zone, no. He was never in my zone, he was never in my zone, no, no, no.
Now I want to thank you all for your great comments, you know, great suggestions. And we decided to look at T.I. Dollar Sign. You guys know, a lot of people call him T.I. Dollar, Ty Dollar. I don't know how you guys pronounce it, I'm just going to say Ty Dollar Sign. And it's a really cool vocal preset. I'm going to run you through the steps on how to get this in FL Studio and show you the mixing procedure that's involved to get that kind of effect. So I'm going to take you straight into FL Studio and show you how it goes. Drop more suggestions below for next week. Got a lot more stuff coming, so make sure you subscribe. And let's go straight into this. But from that, if you haven't, smash that like button and let's go. Hey guys, what's up? Okay, so here we are in FL Studio, and I'm going to run you exactly through the settings. As you guys can see, I've got my mic input here on 10. This is actually what I use to record the vocals in. Now, I'm using Soundgoodizer, as you can see. Without the Soundgoodizer, it wouldn't sound like this. So to sound like, you know, TI dollar sign, you want to enable the C mode here at the side and on the Soundgoodizer. On your main actual record input, make sure you've got the record set to red here at the bottom when you record. And we just recorded these vocals doing that, you know, so I just press record like this and simply started recording the vocals. This is a quick test. Yeah. I don't know why, but just to show you guys. So that's what we've done. And these are the vocals at the top, same way we've done that, you know, we recorded these vocals and this is what they sound like without any effects. So
I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my zone. You never showed me love, only play games, I show you how it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, she's way past her demon time. Ignores me when she's texting, I don't need a super lie.
Wait, I just made it up, you know, trying to build that like Ty Dolla Sign kind of wave preset, I don't know, slash path, because I always put my little style in it, as you guys know. But okay, what do we do? So once you record your vocals, which I have on here, this is going to be the main vocals. I'm going to set them to channel 11, so you guys, you know, set your any channel on the screen you have, and we'll set the channel, and then obviously we need to add the effects. So straight away, first thing, auto tune EFX here, straight at the top, with alter and tenor effect. The key is set to D and the scale is minor. Obviously this will reflect on your actual beat, you know, if it don't sound right, you have selected the wrong scale for your beat, and that's why you need to fix it. So you need to make sure you select the right scale, D minor, you know, I'm using the C, D, E, F, G and A, as you can see, and most of these other keys are blanked out. This is a perfect kind of T dollar sign kind of preset. You know, this is the kind of perfect beat for him as well. But obviously you will need to match this. Now on here, the retune speed is set to 3 and the humanize halfway. So anything between 45 and 50. I went for like 49, 50, halfway. You know, that few points won't have any change. But once you do that, your volume will sound like this. Well, your effect, should I say.
I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my zone. You never showed me love, only play games, I show you how it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, she's way past her demon time.
And now it's perfect, you know, if you've got that auto-tune kind of effect, and we just need to uplift the vocals a bit. So we're using a Soundgoodizer again, this time with B mode. And once we use this B mode on here, it will sound much better. Oh, my bad. I just realized that I need to push these forward a bit because of the camera. So this is the Soundgoodizer. I'm using mode B on here. And this will give us this kind of sound. I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my. And we're gonna turn the vocals down to 85%. I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in. 85, you know. I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my zone. You never showed me love, only play games. And then what we do is we add fruity compressor. Okay, and these are the settings that you guys want to set. So these are the settings that I've set up, and it took me a while to get these. So what you want to do, I'm going to run through these and you guys want to write them down on check here at the hint panel. But simply the threshold is minus 18 dB on a low band, ratio 2:1, the knee 80%, attack 10.1 milliseconds, release 109 milliseconds, and the gain is 0.7 dB. On the midband, we've got minus 13.2 decibels, ratio 2:1, knee 100%, attack 4.5 milliseconds, release 693.1 milliseconds, and the gain 2 decibels. Now on the high band, we've got the threshold set to 21.5 decibels, ratio 2:1, the knee 84%, attack 0.1 milliseconds, ratio, well, the release 10 milliseconds all the way down to the bottom, and the gain is just on zero, just perfectly there. And this will turn our vocals from sounding like this. I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my zone. You never showed me love. To sounding like this. I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my zone. You never showed me love, only play games, I show you how it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, she's way past the demon time. Ignores me when she's texting, I don't need it. Now we're gonna turn the volume up to about 88 to 90% to match our volume output. I've been way too numb, stop Now at the bottom here, what you wanna do is you wanna add something called the soft clipper. Just like that. I've been way too numb, stop. And also on the slot 4, what we're gonna do is we're gonna add something called Fruity Parametric EQ 2. And what this is gonna do is we're gonna just EQ the vocals to sound a bit more like TR dollar sign. So we're just gonna add vocal presence on here. So go on preset, run you again, select the drop down, preset, and vocal presence. So drop down, preset, and vocal presence. Now I showed you that 3 times. If you get that wrong, I don't know, like, you need to learn how to use the PC. And then what this will do is we set this up, we're going to drag the first one up like this, the second one we're going to drag it up just a little milestone, and the last one just notch. So just with, you know, this little kind of notch, we're not gonna change the frequencies too much, but we're gonna just significantly give him that vocal kind of presence on the EQ 2. I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my zone. You never showed me love, only play games, I show you how it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then once you do this, the settings, okay, you're gonna right click, go on file, and save mixer track state. And I'm gonna call this the main TA dollar, you know, or just the TYD. And this is the main TYD preset that I have on here. I'm gonna go to 12, go on file, and open mixer state, and I'm gonna find that TYD. I just saved it here. And this will preload the same effects I used for channel 11 into channel 12, just like that. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna clone these vocals, okay? So on 11 here, we've got them, obviously the main vocals. On channel 12, we're gonna have the reverb. Okay. So main vocals and channel 12 is gonna be the reverb. So to obviously we're gonna add some reverb to this, but I just want the same kind of settings, and we're just gonna add a bit of reverb and change a few things on there. So obviously we've cloned this down. Well, we're gonna clone down the main vocals. Now this is in two parts. It took me two parts to record, so I need to select both of them. I'm gonna select the pen tool here at the top, and I'm gonna hold shift on my keyboard and just drag down like this. Now if this is not clipping to the one below, like so, you need to make sure your magnet is set to cell. If you've not got the cell selected, when you actually select these and drop down, it will just go anywhere. And what I mean by that is, I'll show you. See that? It doesn't stick to anything, and that's not what we want. So once you have it here at the bottom, obviously I'm gonna enable it and play. Now we've got two auto tunes playing over each other, and it's just too loud. You know, we've got two layers of this, so we need to separate this. So we need to make the one at the bottom that we just added unique. So click on this little waveform and click on make unique. This will now have a little hashtag 2 at the end. As you can see, the one at the end here still hasn't got a hashtag, so we need to do that again. Make unique. And now both of them are unique. As you can see, they're both at the bottom, have hashtag 2. Obviously, if it was going to make it unique, it'll be hashtag 3, 4 and whatever. But that means that this vocal here is different from the one at the top, which means I can now take this one and put it into channel 12 and the one next to it as well. Now, if we didn't do that, I'm going to show you an example here at the bottom. If we had, you know, we just cloned it like that and we changed this one to 14, let's say, they would both change, as you can see. So whatever you do to this sample will happen to the ones that clone of it, and that's why we had to make it unique, so it doesn't affect it when we change it to a different effect output. So much talking. So now you guys understand what that does. Let me just play that back now. I've been way too numb, stop pretending now. Now we can control the second part. I've been way too numb, so what we're gonna do on the second part is, first thing, take away the auto tune. Okay, I've been way too we're gonna turn the volume down. I've been way too numb, and we're gonna add something called Fruity Reverb 2. Leave it on full blast. I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my soul. Then what we're gonna do is add something called Panajament 2. Now you guys get this, you guys can get this from Producer Buzz, link in more description, it's free. And you're gonna select decay halfway, wetness halfway, make sure this is in the middle, and the size, just turn it down just between the middle here. I've been way too numb. So this is the kind of effect we have on the reverb itself. I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my soul. You never showed me love, only play game. Now on the Fruity multiband, we're gonna kill the lows, okay, just like that, the fruit parametric EQ. And on the multiband, we're gonna take the low and just move it down halfway to -8 dB. I'm gonna take the highs and move it up to 5.1, and this is the output we get now. Now when we mix them with the one, when we mix both of them together, this is what we get. I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my zone. You never showed me love, only play games, I show you how it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, she's way past her demon time. Ignores me when she's texting, I don't need a super lie. He was never in my zone, he was never in my zone, no. He was never in my zone, he was never in my zone, no, no, no. That is perfect, sounds really nice. Check this out. Now, there might be too much highs, so just take it down 3.6, just like that. If you've got too much of the highs in there, just take it down. Only play games, I show you how it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, she's way past her demon time. Ignores me when she's texting, I don't need a super lie. Okay, so you guys can hear that perfect reverb. You know, you can stick it between 50% and 60%, anywhere, you know, depending on what kind of output you like. I'm just going to leave it here at 55 with the main vocals stuck at 88, 89. And this is the kind of, you know, we turn the vocals from sounding like this so far.
I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my s-
to, you know, then we added a reverb and we added the main vocals to this.
I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my song, you never showed me.
Now on the reverb, you can leave the auto-tune on or auto-tune off. I like to just take it off and remove it because it gives us that clear kind of background noise, you know, just without any effect, that main kind of sound that we should have. And it also, it goes easy on the CPU, and it's there, it's silent, it's in the background, so it doesn't really matter that much. And I kind of like to work that way. When you listen to TI Dolla Sign, you don't really want to notice the background reverb too much. That's why we've kind of got rid of the lows, just left the highs in there, just to give us that nice kind of atmosphere. And that's what we want. We're looking for atmosphere, not crazy effects. And that's why we get rid of the auto-tune on the reverb. So that's pretty much it, you know, main vocals and reverb. And this is how it goes, simple as that.
I've been way too numb, stop pretending that you're in my zone. You never showed me love, only play games, I show you how it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, she's way past the demon time, ignores me.
And this is basically it. Like TI Dolla Sign is probably the most easiest vocal preset that I've made. That's what I just showed you guys. This, you know, kind of universal preset, Wiz Khalifa, TI Dolla Sign, many other artists kind of use the same kind of preset when it comes to mixing vocals. But this is a very simple kind of preset. You guys can download it from my description, and let's go straight back out. All right, guys, so I just want to thank you for watching. Again, if you've got any questions, just drop them below. Let me know what you guys think, what you guys want to see here next week. Apart from that, stay safe, make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you again soon. Peace out.